So Donald, the hardest working man in Ireland, Gleeson, it's a pleasure to meet you.
I'm not going to respond to that. That is not true, but sure. Yes, yeah. Just Donald's good.
You're taking a few months off now back in Ireland. Are you enjoying this unwinding, I presume? Because it was a pretty busy 2017.
It was very busy 2017, both in terms of, like, I did Peter Rabbit at the start of the year, then I did a Lenny Abrahamson film in the summer in England, and then I had, like, I think 5 or 6 films out at the end of the year, so just a lot of travelling around, talking rubbish, you know, about myself, which is not, you know, which is great for a while, don't get me wrong, but then after a while, I guess even I get bored of me, so that was a strange one, but yeah, no, now I'm kind of, once we're done with this, I'm kind of into a very easy stretch.
Good to know. Mm. The most soul-searching question I'm going to ask, are you happy now with the double whammy Star Wars and now Peter Rabbit, that kids are going to be terrified and possibly traumatised when they see it?
Well, I'm hoping that Peter Rabbit offers a kind of a little bit of a solution. You know, what I'm hoping is that I don't get, like kicked in the balls or anything by any kids as they pass by. That would be kind of be the nightmare, because I get beaten up in this film quite a bit. They seem to take a lot of pleasure in hurting me. So I'm hoping that doesn't play out on the streets of Dublin. But apart from that, I think it should be okay. By the end of this film, I think you're kind of on my guy's side, hopefully, a bit.
It was funny, actually. I think the last time you called my colleague Owen mentioned, you said the one film you had to watch at Christmas was Home Alone. Yeah. And even watching this, I was thinking, geez, there's some scenes. It felt like I was watching Harry and Marv.
Yeah.
When you were doing the slapstick stuff. That must have been really fun to play.
It was, and it was exactly... It was exactly the kind of stuff that I wanted to do, you know. Like you say, Home Alone is like one of my favorite films, not from being a kid, just one of my favorite films, full stop. And there are elements of that in this. I mean, it's not all the way through, but there is great joy in seeing somebody get hurt. So it was good to kind of see. I liked it. Good to be the guy.
You know? And on that note, your Sideshow Bob impression with Rakes is top notch, I have to say.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I've got the hair to do it. So it was funny what we were doing. I was like, I mean, we do know Sideshow Bob did this, and they're like, yes, it's all fine. It'll be fine.
It's fine. Flat, you know, imitation.
Exactly.
Finest form of flattery. On that note, actually, while I was watching, I was just thinking, I would have loved you to do the Father Ted approach to dealing with rabbits. Just say,
they keep on turning up more and more. They keep on turning up in the house. I'm not sure that would have been family friendly, but I think, well, in a way, that is kind of what happens. I mean, the house does just keep on filling up with animals. So, God, yeah. I mean, I don't think it's a definitive reference to Father Ted, but I'd be happy for it to be.
No CGI rabbits were hurt during the film.
No, I wouldn't have thought so.
In doing so, actually, it does kind of touch back with your slapstick roots, with particularly your bad self. That must have been fun when it was John Hamm just picked up on and said, like, randomly said, "Oh, I loved the sketch stuff you did."
Yeah.
It kind of does tie back in a way, wouldn't it?
Yeah, we shot, like, a few of us here shot those together, which is absolutely mad.
Bravo,
yeah. Made a lasting impression. It's been like, it's been such a strange thing that those sketches have really, really, like, hung around. Like, an actor who I absolutely adore came up to me recently and said it. One of the old guard now, and I was like, how the hell did that happen? Like, I don't know how it gets around, but it did, and it's kind of cool. It's really nice that we made them so long ago, and they're still making people laugh.
And I love the fact that people now aren't, like, terrified of Michael McElhattan, thinking he's, like, shit scary. Like, oh my God, he actually has a real sense of humor, Roose Bolton. I'm not afraid of him anymore.
But he did Pastor Freedom as well, man. That's the one to seek out. Have you seen Pastor Freedom?
Yeah.
I see a man, you know, like, he's a comedy legend. He's great, yeah.
Obviously, actually, on that note, the X-Men gets famous. I presume you're shopping that around Hollywood and say, here, look at me, I'm an X-Men, put me in it.
That's my audition for X-Men. Yeah, I don't know. It will be hilarious. I mean, it will be really funny to end up in X-Men just because of that sketch. They could be like an extra on the DVD, but I don't think that's going to happen.
On that note, you've nailed Potter and Star Wars. Is there anything, other franchises that kind of you might be interested in yourself? I know that probably pops up a lot.
No. I mean, I loved them. I don't know if it's a franchise, but they certainly made a sequel to Blade Runner that I thought was absolutely beautiful and a really cool movie. So I liked that. I'm trying to think if there's any other of the sequel-y type things. Oh, man, I'd be happy to hop on board Paddington. That was a pretty amazing film. My dad's already done that. So there's a few of them around, yeah. If they make a sequel to Phantom Thread, that seems like the start of a franchise for sure.
You just want to edge in on all the family members' good stuff, is that right?
That's what I'm trying to do, yeah. Take jobs from my family.
Not happy with just the hardest working man, you just want to be like, you know, the most, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I've got to be the hardest working man in my family first. That'll take some doing.
We're in the season now. We actually caught with Martin McDonagh a few weeks ago.
Oh,
he's writing something with your dad and Colin in mind, I was thinking, Jesus, you know, you single-handedly won him the Oscar for Six Shooter, your cashier role. You know, you should...
I'm owed a part at this point.
Exactly.
No, I mean, no, I don't think that's going to happen. You know, Martin is kind of out on his own track, but I've seen everything he's done. I mean, like, I saw Hangman and he's got another play this year. Like, he operates at such a level. Like, yeah. I mean, I'd go in and do a line for him or a wave in the background or a pass by in the background if he needs it, but I don't think he does. I think everybody's clamoring to work with Martin nowadays.
Hasn't given you the text message anyway.
Got
for
nothing
that new
yet. Project. No. I doubt he has a phone.
And on that note, obviously, delighted for Saoirse now, third nomination going forward. What do you think going ahead for her chances? And obviously, the Irish guy's Martin as well for Best Picture.
It's unbelievable. Like, we're just... You know, we're just such heavy hitters. I mean, Saoirse is kind of leading the Irish front, really, because she's just, the level of work she's been doing for such a long time, for such a young person. She's outstanding. And it's weird, I know a few people now who are kind of nominated and stuff this year, but I feel like the films this year have just been unbelievably good, so it's kind of cool. Yeah, I like I'm excited for all of them. I've got a hard time picking my favourites, which is always good.
A lot of good TV work as well. Just mentioning your bad self there. You've got Derry Girls and Young Offenders also as well. Seems to be really registering as well. Right?
Yeah, which I've not seen full episodes of yet, but I'm looking forward to seeing them very much because I hear they're really good, yeah.
And going forward, actually, I know you just mentioned Little Stranger Lenny. Is there anything else in the pipework? I presume just sitting around waiting for JJ, hopefully, to give you that call, come back?
You never know, yeah. Yeah, we'll wait and see if that works out. And in the meantime, I'm happy just to ramble around Dublin and... just chill out, it's nice.
It's funny, actually, you mentioned Little Stranger. I think I picked up something you said. It was one of the most demanding roles you had. I said it took a bit out of you. Is there anything you can kind of just tease us with that?
Not really. It was a very intense shoot, but working with Lenny kind of makes it easy, so because you can just trust him at every turn. So he was... It was an emotionally demanding shoot, but like that's what you want. You want to feel tired at the end of the day, to feel like you've done real work. And I think we were all tired at the end of the day, so it was nice.
Well, Domhnall, if there's an Oscar for getting beaten up by a rabbit, I think you'd be up there with Bob Hoskins and Elmer Fudd.
I hope there is an Oscar for getting beaten up by a rabbit. That would be great. I better be a shoe-in.
You'll get the win. Anyway, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Only the beginning.